Hi, I'm Peter Naude. I've been at Manchester Business School since 1988 and I joined here after a period in consulting. I guess I really wear two hats at the business school. On the one hand, I'm Professor of Marketing, where my particular interest is business-to-business marketing. And on the other hand, I'm also the Deputy Director. There are four Deputy Directors here. I'm one of the four, and my particular remit is to look after academic programs. So in that sense, the buck for the MBA and the quality on the MBA stops here. As you probably know, the IB project is the capstone project which our students do after they've already completed 15 months of the course, whereas the usual course is 12 months and most other universities, ours is 18. So they do 15 months and then they spend the last 3 months doing an IB project where they work in self-selected teams, typically of 5 or 6 students, and they have to solve a practical problem for a real company that has an international dimension to it. And perhaps the easiest thing to do is to give you a sense of what these kind of projects are. So if I think of the last few years, last year, for example, a company came to us and said, what will the future be like for the gaming industry in China and in the US? And if you think of the big competitors are probably companies like Zynga, who does Farmville, and Angry Birds is another big market leader. How do we take on companies like that, and what does the future of the online gaming industry look like? So that was an interesting high-tech kind of project. Different kinds of projects have involved, what is the market for home security systems in Spain? Now, obviously, that's quite easy to do because you can simply go and speak to a whole lot of households and find out what kind of security systems they use. But you simply can't do that in 10 weeks. So really, this was a routes to markets problem, where who can we speak to that has the most information and can speak on behalf of the typical homeowner? So we cracked that by speaking to a lot of the insurance companies and a lot of the intermediaries in that marketplace. Another one was, what is the market for compactors in India? A compactor is something about the size of a Sherman tank that you use to compact landfill sites. And obviously, there's an awful lot of household rubbish is generated in India. So how do you service that market from the UK if you're selling these massive machines? Another typical project has involved a drug company who came to us and said, thinking of selected countries around the world, should we or should we not drop our prices by 5%? So this is a demand elasticity or price elasticity problem. How do you measure price elasticity of demand for drugs, given that efficacies of drugs vary across different prescriptions? So we came up with some good conclusions that have allowed one of the world's biggest drug companies to selectively price their products around the world. Another example, and the last one I'll use, is a large sweet manufacturer came to us and said, how should we enter the market for chewing gum within China? Now, 5 minutes on the internet shows you that the current incumbent had about a 40 or 45% market share in China. So it wasn't a market entry strategy, it was a direct competitor strategy. How do we take on one of the world's biggest sweet companies and try and succeed in China? And succeed they have. So these are the kinds of projects that we do. They are large projects. They are almost always of great strategic significance to the company that's involved. And we like to think that in 10 weeks, so you will have access to 6 people for 10 weeks. So that's 60 man weeks. And that is all that the students work on, working 7 days a week over 10 or to 12 weeks. We think we deliver fantastic value for you. And that is why we have so many clients that come back to us year after year.